Hey everybody, what is going on? This is Pedro from Music by Pedro. Actually, you can't see me right now because I've got the camera pointing down because I want to share some stuff with you guys and the camera needs to be not on my face. Hope you guys are doing well. And today I'm going to share something that I haven't actually shared with anybody actually. And I thought it would be kind of cool to kind of show you what it's like to be a musician on the road and some of the things that you have to get and you have to keep with you when you work on the road. Now, there are some challenges when you're out there, and the main one is problems, okay? You know, obviously being on the road means you have to be able to take care of whatever issue comes around. So I put together this guy here. This is the emergency music kit, and it is something that I take with me everywhere I go. One of the cool things about it is that it's got basically anything and everything that I could ever need should anything happen with my instrument other than just it being flattened by a dump truck or a tank, okay? These things that I'm going to share with you are things that you can buy yourself. I put this kit together myself. Some companies do have the kit put together with their own tools and their own brands and stuff, but I kind of did this a little bit as I went along, so I had all the tools. I had no need to go into purchasing a full kit when I already had a lot of the things that the kit came with. No use for me to have redundancy. I'm not a fan of that. And always, as you guys know, if I don't like something or if I don't want something, I don't like to just have it, multiple copies of it laying around. So anyways, I'm gonna go over each item and share a little bit of what it's like, what each item does. And you'll probably be surprised that there are some things in here that you wouldn't think should be in a repair kit, but I'll tell you why they work. So the first thing is a saxophone, flute, clarinetist. The first thing you see here is the screwdriver kit. Super, super important to have a screwdriver kit, especially flathead. A lot of the screws in these instruments are flatheads. So it's very, very important to have a good kit, okay? Here it is right there. I'm gonna put it to the side here so it's not anywhere. A saxophone has a lot of felt pads that stop basically the metal from hitting other metals. Now, the ones that I've got put on are special Teflon things, but they don't sell little pads like that in the market. I got this at a hardware store, and these are just little felt pads that you can buy for furniture or for like a lamp if you don't want it scraping your surface or anything like that. They're pretty cool because you can just peel it off. Let me see. You can just take it off and boom, just like that. And you can just peel it and stick it where you need in case you lose a felt pad. Sometimes, you know, it's just about noise. Sometimes they actually do have a purpose, and it's important to have something like this in case you happen to lose a pad as you're in the middle of a gig, or maybe you get to a gig and you realize something fell off during transport, okay? So felt pads is very, very important. As a saxophone player, you guys know you can never have too many neck straps. Very, very important to have neck straps. I have that big harness that I wear, which I'm gonna review more in depth in another video. But this harness, this saxophone harness, there's nothing special about it. It just is what it is. It just will be here in case I need a backup saxophone strap, okay? So I just put it on and it helped me get through the gig. The last thing you wanna do is play a whole gig without a saxophone neck strap. I have done that. It is extremely painful because all the weight now sits on your right thumb instead of on your neck or along your shoulders, okay? So neck strap, gotta have them. You wanna have one somewhere where you can always grab it in case you forget your main one. I also have a cleaning swab. And the cleaning swab is great because you just never know the humidity in some places. If you're playing outdoors, sometimes your instrument will get a lot of condensation. And so having one is good. Get one that has a little weight at the end of the string. These are much easier to work with, and that way it'll make it a quick motion instead of you having to really twirl the instrument around upside down while you're trying to find the thin end of this thing. The weight really helps the instrument just kind of, you know, drop down into the bell or up the neck or whatever it is that you're trying to swab, okay? So very standard. This is a chamois cloth one. I don't recommend the neck savers, you know, those little fluffy looking things, because if you just run your hands through them, and I'll probably talk about it a little bit more on the do's and don'ts as far as accessories to have, that stuff will just stay inside the instrument. A lot of it will get built up inside the pads, and it'll create a long-term problems for you. And I'm talking like serious, serious problems. But I'll talk about that a little bit more later. Yeah, just a nice neck swab. Not a neck swab, but just a body swab. This can actually go through my clarinet as well. And that's one of the things that I like about it. It's very versatile. So it'll go through my saxophone and my clarinet. The next thing that I have is a spring hook. Now this guy, it's already creeping out of the bag. Well, I might have to do it like this. So a spring hook is very important. Saxophones, clarinets, and flutes have springs to keep the keys from staying down or staying up. They go back to the position they're supposed to be in. Now this guy has a hook. You might be able to see it. Has a hook there, and then it's got a push option here. Let me see. I doubt it'll get, yeah, it looks like it's getting in. So this one's for pushing a hook, and this one's for hooking one thing. There we go, right there, you can see it. See that it hooks. So it hooks and you pull, okay? A nice little tool to have. You can get this at specialty stores. I will list one where you can get one. Very, very important thing to have, because sometimes you can't reach those springs, and if you just need to get in and out quick and pop that spring back where it's supposed to go, this is definitely the tool to have. All right. You know, it's funny. I've been carrying this eraser around for a while, and you're probably thinking, like, Pedro, why do you need an eraser? Sometimes some of the music that I have has a lot of marks on it, and they're old marks. And so it's important to be able to erase them in case we don't use those marks. And, you know, it can be very confusing if you're already trying to sight read a piece, and then you're already on top of it trying to remember where it was that you're not supposed to read the marks. And then sometimes you are supposed to read the marks. So for me, it's always, I'm a stickler about that kind of stuff. So if I see something that needs to be erased, I'll just go ahead and take care of it and erase it, and let someone else draw it in later if it needs to be written back in. For broken springs, the spring hook doesn't do anything. And unfortunately, there's not much you can do. However, I do carry these rubber bands around, and basically what you can do with them is you can tie them together like so and wrap them around the instrument so that it creates the spring that it needs to pop that key back in place. You might want to look into how to pop, you know, how to use the rubber bands, but it kind of makes sense. I mean, you just literally just somehow tie them so that it, you know, creates force along the two points, and then it'll pop them back in place or pull them off, whatever you need to. But I have had to use one of these before, and it was very, very handy to have, because the last thing you want is having to play with one finger and then having to go around and lift the key back up. That can get very annoying and uncomfortable. I also have a general cleaning cloth, which is, you know, just a t-shirt, basically, that I cut up. As you can tell, I'm not very good at cutting cloth. And I use this for swabbing out, you know, my flute or doing some general cleaning if that need be. So this is just one that I take with me wherever I go. And once it gets dirty, I'll just throw it away. But I still got some good life on it. This guy here is a wedge tool. And this guy is used to realign any pads that aren't quite sealing all the way. Now you can look into how to use this guy. I don't recommend you use it just to use it. Don't use it unless you absolutely have to, because if you don't know how to use it, then you'll mess up the pad completely and it'll just be even worse than before. So you gotta make sure you know how to do this. But I do know how to do this, and I only use it unless I really feel like I need to. I think I may have used it once on a pad that just didn't feel like it was closing all the way, and I was able to see that it just wasn't seating properly. The key wasn't falling flat on the keyhole like it was supposed to. So I used this wedge tool to bend one side to compensate for the other, and so on and so forth. Let's see. The other situation that we have, let me see, I got some more stuff here. I've got these teeth mark mouthpiece guards, sorry. These mouthpiece guards are by Van Doren, and these are probably the best. Let me bring these up a little bit so you can see them. These are the best mouthpiece guards that I have ever played on. I've seen the little black ones that are all cushiony and stuff, and I've seen the clear ones that are a little bit more cushiony. I've played on those, but they don't last more than 2-3 months. of playing. These guys I'm able to keep for probably close to a year sometimes before it's time to replace them. They are very, very strong, and the glue is very, very good. So it stays in place until you absolutely just need to replace it. It won't fall off. You'll need to replace it before it falls off. So these are made by Van Doren. They make, I believe they make different sizes. I'm not sure if they do. They might make a bigger one, I think, for Barry. But I use this for all of them, and I'm very happy with it. I don't have any complaints. I was like, the only complaint, I don't have any complaints. So these are the Van Doren mouthpiece guards. You get them in a pack of six. I bought these recently because I needed to have one. And I have another box of six back in my spare box, just in case, because I hate running out of these, because then you have to play on the mouthpiece and it just feels different to me, and I don't like to change things like that in the middle of a gig. So anyways, this is very important. Keep in mind that if you do wash your mouthpiece with soap and stuff, you could get soap underneath the mouthpiece guard, and then it will want to fall off because you'll get water underneath it. And soap, I guess soap is the biggest problem. I had an issue before where I washed my mouthpieces because it was time to clean them, and I let them soak for a few hours in some Dawn and a little bit of vinegar, I think, and so that cleans up everything, sterilizes them really well. But unfortunately, all the glue from the mouthpiece guards peeled off on some mouthpieces, so I ended up having to replace them. That's why I got this and a second pack. So yeah, this is good to have them. Okay. So along with all these tools, is even more important to have a little Leatherman. Now this is my a tool that I got from my dad as a birthday present when I was younger, and I absolutely love it. So basic things that it's got, obviously it's got pliers in case I need to grab anything, I can do that. It's got knives, it's got scissors, it's got screwdrivers. Now these screwdrivers will work a little bit better for major instruments, for bigger instruments. But it's a great tool to have. You just never know when you're gonna need it. Not only as a instrument repair tool, but just the overall tool to need. If you're ever stuck on the road, you'll never know when you might need this, and you'll remember it because it's probably your biggest tool in your box. I always like to keep a set of batteries. Now these batteries go with my stand light. I have a battery operated stand light that is also power operated. So if it's plugged in, it works fine. Sometimes you don't have access to electricity and you need to be able to run on batteries. And I always have a pair of these just because the ones that I have in the light itself could go out at any moment. You don't want to get caught with that. Your last thing you want to do is try to read music in the dark. So last but not least is this guy here. This is the craziest tool that I use to get rid of sticky pads. Now, sticky pads is something that you run into in saxophones, you run into it on clarinets, and you run into it on flutes. However, the dollar bill works great by itself. It works even better with this stuff here. Now, before you guys get into it too much, this is not what you think it is. This is actually called Teflon powder. Now, Teflon powder, it's pretty interesting because what you basically do is you take the dollar bill and you rub the powder over it. And then you take the dollar bill and you rub it over the sticky pad. And the powder does two things. The Teflon powder absorbs any moisture or anything that is causing the pad to stick, but it also creates a smooth seal. So you won't have to worry about it creating any sort of stickiness when you close the pad, you know, like that suction sound when you pop the pad back up. So the powder actually coats it. Now there are, I believe Van Doren or someone out there, I can't remember. If you know who it is, please let me know. Yamaha makes these sheet powder pads or sticky papers or something like that. And it's basically the same thing. It's basically a talc powder, baby powder, or whatever you wanna call it, on a sheet of paper. This is a little bit more rugged, a little bit more sturdy. So I'm able to get more uses out of this instead of just one sheet at a time. So I basically have this powder in here, and I'll take it and I'll rub it on the dollar bill, and then the dollar bill goes underneath the keys. So that is basically it, guys. And the cool thing about it is that everything fits in here without any issues, which is probably my favorite thing about this little case. I'm a little bit OCD about stuff, so I always like to label them so that if people ever find them, you know, they know what it is and how to use it and all that kind of stuff. So there are other companies out there that do make emergency repair kits like this. Like I said, they have all the tools that you would need. But I started buying these things left and right, you know, a little bit, one piece a year. And it's not that they're expensive. I just didn't have the need. Once I started playing more and I started being away from home and away from my local repair guy, it was definitely inevitable that I needed to get a kit together that could take care of everything for me. So this is it, guys. If you guys have any questions about any of the things that I said here, please let me know in the comment sections below. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.